everyone. Today I'm going to show you how to remove backgrounds from images using Cutout 8. This is a software, this is the interface what you see once you open Cutout 8. And on the left side you can see the folders. You can browse through the pictures in your system which you want to edit. And on clicking off that, right, on selecting the folder, you will see the pictures or the images on the right side. And here you have different options, different menus. Right, select the picture, you will see a menu, and here you can select the action that you want to perform, whether you want to view, do a cutout, or you want to edit the picture, do some transformation, etc. If you don't want to go through menu, just select the picture, then click one of this icon. If you want to remove the background, you have to select this cutout option. So I have two pictures here. One is with a plain background and another one is with a some greenery in the background. So it's a bit complex background, right? So we are going to do this first, the one with plain background, right? Select that picture. Click on cutout. Now you will get this pop-up window where you can see what type of matting you want to do, right? So there are three options. One is stroke based matting, second is inside outside edge matting, and the third one is chroma key. Okay, so I'm going to choose chroma key. So it says one click fast matting, works only for pure blue and green background. Here we have a white background. I am going to try with that, right? I have selected that option, right? So now you are in the chroma key matting interface, right? This is our picture with a pure white background, and these are the tools, these are the options available. You can select the feather, then you can increase or decrease whatever this one, right? Whatever you want. Select the, I'm going to select the eyedrop tool, select it, and just click on the area where you want to remove the background. Here I want to remove this white, click there, and just removing it, and done. You can see it removed the background, it's perfect. Alright, if you want to check, test the results, okay, with pure color background, click on this option here, right? See, you can see everything is cleaned up. All right, so now once you're done, you can click on apply and return. So this will show another pop-up. Right, if you want to change the background, you can do that, or if you want to save this image which you have removed background as a PNG file or JPEG, you can click. Right, I want to retain the transparent background, so I'm saving it as PNG, right? Okay, done. So you have that image without the background, right? Now I'm trying to remove, change this background, right? Change the background, click on change the background. Select the background image that you want to choose. You want to use it. I'm just selecting one random picture. Right, now you will get this window. Click on OK. You're done. Now I'm just transforming it. I'm making it small so it looks nice. Or I can do it here. Wherever I want to move it, I can move it. Right. I'll keep it here. Click on OK. That's it. You can see. Now we can save this image. Right. It's a JPEG file. Click on OK. You already have ones. Just click. Alright. This is one option for a blank. You have seen like how to remove background with a single, I mean if the background is a single color using chroma key, right? Now we are going to do the second picture, this one. Select the picture, click on cutout. Right now select this option, inside, outside, edge matting, right? It's a small picture. Okay, I'm zooming in, right? So these are the various options that you have, or the tools you have. Right, first you have to select outside. Click on the outside polygon tool. Just quickly select like this. It does not have to be accurate. Just click whatever you want to retain. Just draw an outline like this. Connect it. Done. Now go and select the inside polygon tool, right? And start selecting the inside, whatever foreground that you want to retain. Just select, right, and do this. Yes, now you see two lines. One is the outside selection and second one is inside, right? All right. Now see, just click on matting. That's it, you're done. You can test the results like we did before, right? Now click on apply and return, and I am saving the result. This is a transparent monkey cutout, and I just want to try change backgrounds. Well, let me select the background. Right, this time I'll go for different background, right? Okay, let me choose this. Alright, and your monkey is here sitting on the corner, right? Simple as that. It's very easy, right, to remove the background, right? I'm selecting it and you can save it. Okay, so you have various options, and if you want to edit one of the image, let me go, I think these are the ones I just edited, right? Right, I'm just viewing it. See, you can view the image. So the ones which we removed background now, right? If you want to edit it, just edit it. Then you have various options. You can change the exposure, you can change the color, you can do the filterings, you have various filters, right? Color filter, there are many options. You can try it out. Right, so right, let's go and see the background images edited and kept the background. See, look, this one, let's see how it looks. All right, looks nice. Thank you. This is how you, I hope this was helpful. If you, these are some of the other images that I've done. Right. All these are done using cutout. Right. Thank you. If you like the video, if you think it's helpful, please subscribe, please like. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.